Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
I have no idea why I just got up. But I have no idea what's going on. And of course, I can't wake up. Also, I'm trying to figure out, I can't figure out my password. What can I figure it out to, Rob?
And you gotta reset the password. You gotta open up your profile.
On Twitter?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I can't figure out how to even do that.
Yeah, well, what? I wish I could be there to show you.
You do?
You're not a very good, whatever.
No. No, I'm a very good. You're not a very good.
No, you're not fat, stupid.
No, you're an idiot. But,
what?
You're an idiot.
Excuse me?
I'm an idiot?
Yeah.
Be nice. This is the last day almost, huh? Come on, be nice.
Where the heck have you been? God,
don't you screw this up for Bernard either.
Be nice.
Jerk. Bernie, hey, what's going on, Bernie? Anything?
Well, we talked yesterday about the dictator of North Korea, the dear leader.
Yeah.
Was he or was he not in China? Yes, he was in China. There are pictures. It was almost like a state visit. He was there for that. And
Was he there? I mean, what was the deal?
Well, it looks like it's all speculation. But it looks like China wants to, he's scheduled to meet with the president of South Korea, with the United States president, and China wanted to get in on the act. They're like, hey, yo, we're big actors in this too.
Yeah, come on.
So that's one reason they say, they posit that he was there. But he unfortunately, it wasn't one of those deals where they're going to kidnap him and say, you know, allow a coup in Pyongyang, which was something I was hoping for personally, but it didn't happen. And also, there's this big to-do about the census, asking people whether or not they're citizens of the country. And also, it's easier now to get high in New Jersey.
Why's that?
Governor Murphy, he signed a law that says medical marijuana is legal now.
Well, maybe.
Geraldo Rivera's coming up this morning. He's got a... Well, you say, well, why is he on? Well, he's an old friend of mine, but that's not why. He's got this book called The Geraldo Show, and we initially canceled him, some parents, didn't we, Rob?
Yeah.
And why did we put him back on?
Because you got a phone call.
I got an email from Marty Berman.
Mm-hmm.
A rather persuasive one. And so he's on. And the book is called The Geraldo Show, and it's a memoir. And there's some new stuff in it.
Whoa.
He hammers, what's her name?
Bette Midler.
the one who went over to NBC.
Oh, Megyn Kelly.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So some ugliness there. Oh, and then Deirdre, Imus, and Wyatt Imus will be on in the little after 7.
Awesome.
And then the great Delbert McClinton.
Ooh. Yeah.
And Connell McShane.
Hey, Connell.
Woo!
Delbert was the one who, of course, crushed my dream. Oh, he's happy about that. Because I told you about that, didn't I?
Yes.
Well, not good.
Oh, well, we'll straighten him out today.
Sid, what do you have coming up?
A lot of TV stuff for the NFL. Our man Dan Patrick is walking away from NBC after 9 years.
He will no longer.
He doesn't want to do it anymore. He's 62.
They offered him 5 years.
They offered him a 5-year deal. He's like, I don't want to do it.
So there's a job opening there.
Yes.
Yes, Tony. Sign
but
up.
But unfortunately for you, there's another black guy already taking it.
Damn it.
Mike Tirico. Oh, looks like he's going to get the job.
Not really.
What, really?
Mike Tirico?
Yes.
The perv?
He's terrible.
So bad.
Huh? He's so awful.
Yeah, you want to be the guy that follows the guy anyway.
Right. You don't even follow Dan Patrick. And Peyton Manning is like, I'm not doing it. ESPN offered him John Gruden's job. He said no. Then Fox offered him a job. He said no. So Peyton Manning will not be a football announcer, at least not this year, I'm in. And then we've got all the
well, what is he going to do?
Peyton Manning?
Yeah.
He's going to, just do commercials and show up places.
No.
Who's that?
He might coach, huh?
No.
Is this going to be a morning, Sid?
Yeah.
Where I spend all morning
Yeah.
trying to get a hold of you.
No, I'm going to be sitting here the whole time.
It's really frustrating.
You know what's funny?
Do you go through the same thing, Bernie?
Well, Sid moves around a lot. I will say that. He's very.
Is anybody here this morning?
He's very restless.
I'm usually here when you call me, but sometimes I'm talking to Tony or Rob.
Well, what
or
are you doing? Or you leave the studio? Where are you going?
I don't really go anywhere. I got to walk around. It's a very nervous.
He can't sit still.
Yeah, I can't do it.
That's just his personality.
He's got ADD. He can't sit still.
I mean, I remember.
I don't even think it's ADD. I think it's something much more serious.
What do you mean more serious? What does that mean?
It means ADD people do sit down every so often. You never sit down.
You know, I remember the days on MSNBC when they would start the Imus show, and you would have them, the camera, stuck on my chair, which was always empty.
Yeah.
And you would say that's supposed to be Sid's chair, but nobody knows where Sid is. He was at the Republican National Convention last night, and he's not here today. He was in Atlantic City last night.
Well, that's usually because you were drunk, isn't it?
Yes, a lot of the times, yes.
Yeah.
But I'm here.
He's here.
I'm here.
Well, yeah, I know you are, but I mean, I don't know. It's just, but I can't worry about it. Well, I don't have to worry about it after today.
Oh, boy. So, very melancholy.
Why?
Because
I don't understand that.
What don't you understand? I don't.
I don't know. I mean, I don't.
People love you. They're sad.
No, I understand that, and I like them. But I mean, I just don't. Here's the thing. I plan to talk a little bit tomorrow. About all of this, shortly after 7 o'clock, Eastern time. And there's certain aspects of it. But I feel myself getting emotional about it, and it's a great disappointment. I mean, in myself. But why? I mean, nobody's dying. And, you know, it's an appropriate end to what's been, in my view, the greatest radio career ever. So I don't know what there's... I mean, I don't get it. Well, there's a certain aspect of it that I do that I'll talk about tomorrow, but other than that, and then I don't know how I get through that because I do not intend to start blubbering. I mean, stop it. Just stop it.
You're going to disappoint people if you don't cry. I'm just telling you. So do what you want.
Well, when I interviewed you on this program, I mean, that was embarrassing.
Well,
you start blubbering.
I did cry. You know, you just said you're the greatest. You said the greatest career of all time.
Yes.
Yeah. No argument here. Trust me. But you will get some from some people that'll say that even though Imus started the whole thing, that Howard Stern is the greatest of all time. And you would say what to that? I'm serious. I'm serious. But would you? There are people that'll give you the credit for starting it. Some say Howard.
He's one of the five greatest.
But he's not better than you.
No.
Of course not.
Don't be stupid.
But see? I agree.
I mean, he never did anything for anybody. I raised $200 million. I mean, me and the people listening to me raised $200 million for the people who serve this country. For the Intrepid Volunteers Fund, raised about $100 million for kids with cancer. Devoted 20 years of my life to going out to that ranch and nearly died there. What are you talking about? You can't discount that from my body of work, can you?
Well, you can't. No.
Hell no.
No.
So, I mean, that's what I mean, that's the greatest career ever.
And longest. Come on.
Yep.
Thanks, Sid.
I mean, I'm very disappointed in you, Sid.
No. I'm trying to have you clear the record for the morons out there.
People are entitled to think, if they think Howard's the greatest of all time, that's fine with me. I don't have any problem with that. They're wrong, but that's fine.
Right.
Coming up on a quarter after the... They didn't use it in the CBS piece. But Anthony Mason asked me something similar about this feud.
Right.
And I said, I paraphrased Winston Churchill. And I did. I did do this. You're never going to get where you're going if you stop and throw a rock at every dog who barks, which I didn't do. The dogs bark and the caravan rolls on, and I just didn't worry about it. You understand what I'm saying?
The profundities are flying.
Write it down.
Confused there for a second.
And it's early.
The dogs, it was barking.
You worry about everything, Sid.
Yes. Need a pen, Sid? No. Write that down?
It's very philosophical.
It's going to be the. It's going to cost Trump. Well, it's already cost Trump his legacy. But thinking he had to reply to every slight.
Yeah.
It's going to probably ruin his presidency, when his presidency could probably be pretty good. He's got some good ideas, but he can't stop acting like an asshole. So, which I would tell him, but I'm not going to get a chance to talk to him because you guys booked him on your show and said, screw the I-Man.
He almost came on today, Trump, on your show.
What does almost mean?
Well, tell him, Sid.
Well, it was close. Let's just put it that way, but... I think he'll be on with us on Tuesday.
What?
You're such a jerk. Oh, my God. Yep. Oh, man, I love you to death. That's why. That's one of the reasons. That's her.
I remain. It is more serious than ADD. This is much more serious. See, now, there's a prime example. He's all over the place. He's psychotic.
Do we know what we've signed up for here?
I mean, it's coming up on 17 after the hour.
I was on fire. Sit,
Bernie, what's going on in the world?
Hey, what's
okay,
up?
Let's do it, boss. The Japanese prime minister, he's worried about these talks between North Korea and China following this unexpected meeting. The White House, they're worried about the meeting as well. They're watching it closely. And anyway, listen to Sarah Huckabee Sanders. In the news, Lou.
You've also called him a counterpuncher many times. Why is he not punched back on this one?
Look, the president, I didn't say he punches back on every single topic. If he did, he would probably be addressing a lot of the stories that most of you write every single minute of every single day. He also has a country to run, and he's doing a great job with that. That's why the economy is booming. ISIS is on the run. We're remaking the judiciary. He's focused on pushing his agenda.
And the Japanese prime minister, he told a parliamentary meeting Wednesday that Japan has great interest in what happens there, and he wants an explanation from China on what the hell's going on.
Well, he's not going to get one.
No, he's not.
So he needs to pipe down, get the old sword out.
That's right. Or else do something.
Do the right thing. Or jump ugly, one of the two. So.
And Democrats worried, Chief, that the Trump administration's decision to ask people about their citizenship in the 2020 census will cause immigrants to avoid filling out the survey. They would have political consequences, diluting liberal representation for states that tend to vote Democratic and rob communities of federal dollars. Anyway, Congressman Ted Lieu, this screwball from California, he said this.
The American people need to have faith that the figures coming in are accurate. And if you're an immigrant, you might not want to turn that paper in if you think bad things are going to happen to you based on how you answer the questions on the form.
Well, how's he a screwball, Bernie?
Well, he's got a history of being just an absolute total whack job.
All right, 19 after the hour. Time for some sports. And here with that, Sid Rosenberg, is there any football tonight or anything? Is there any kind of sporting activity?
Tonight? Not really. Just some low-level college basketball tournament. Of course, the NCAA basketball tournament resumes I-Man on Saturday. You got the two games, Loyola of Chicago taking on Michigan, then Villanova, Kansas. Tomorrow's a big day for sports fans because it is opening day for baseball. And as I said yesterday, for the first time ever, every single team in the majors will play tomorrow on opening day. It's never happened. Mets will host St. Louis.
It's an historic opening day.
Yankees in Toronto. So a big, big sports day coming up tomorrow to coincide with your big day.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's too much.
Yeah.
Really too much.
They changed it when they found out that tomorrow was Iron Man's last show. They said every team's going to play today. That's it. Right. Major League Baseball. Let's go.
First pitch.
Let's get it in there. Hey, Ronda Rousey was on with
You're an idiot.
This is nuts.
With Mike Golick yesterday. You know Ronda Rousey, Iron Man, the female.
Yes, I do.
Never heard of her.
And you love her, Bernie. Love her.
I know. Yeah, you used to, Bernie.
Yes.
Yeah, but not anymore. She sucks now.
The other girl was my girl, Holly Holm. The one who kicked her ass.
But she lost like four times.
That was brutal, wasn't it?
That was
yes.
brutal. Well, Gunzelman writes here that Ronda Rousey, this is from Guns now, sounds like an idiot when being asked a question by Mike Golick. I man, you be the judge.
Let's go back and start with when you knew from the MMA, when you were done there, when you knew in your mind, I'm not going to fight anymore.
I never said that.
Ah, so there is a possibility that you could go back in time?
There's a possibility that I could go back in time? That's your question to me?
Go back in time and fight. Go back in the octagon.
God.
I do not have the ability to go back in time, no.
No. Would you fight again?
I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Mike Golick.
What a dunce.
That's your ESPN morning show, everybody. Mike Golick.
You've got to be kidding.
No, I swear, that's it.
Yesterday morning. Nationally. On television as well.
Yes, on TV. San Antonio Spurs took a beating yesterday on the court, but their head coach, Greg Popovich, cares less about the team's basketball loss. He's still insane over the president. Almost every day, Pop says something about Donald Trump, including last night.
We're going backwards, at least as far as race is concerned. And take our eye off the ball, and he's great at it. He brings out the dark side of human beings for his own purpose, which is himself.
Wow, Greg Popovich, all over Donald Trump.
He's a creep.
Isn't he? And finally, LeVar Ball's brother, LiAngelo Ball, he was the kid that was detained in China. And it depends on who you believe. Trump says he got him out. His father says he didn't. Well, here's the big news yesterday. Like his brother, LeVar, LiAngelo, following in his brother's footsteps.
Well, I always wanted to be in the NBA since I was a little kid, so it was my goal, really, to declare. So I'm going to be excited to play on any NBA team, really. Whoever picks me up, I'm going to play my hardest for them and try to bring wins to the team.
Isn't that great news, I'm in?
Yes, it is. Pretty exciting. You know, the Voice was on tonight.
It's on tonight?
Yes.
On a Wednesday?
Yes.
Mm.
Yeah. God, didn't you watch it last night?
You know what? I didn't. You know why?
No.
I had to watch Roseanne. I had to. And it was great. Roseanne came back after all these years.
Well, I want to watch it because I have the Voice on tape. And Deirdre and I were wondering when Roseanne was on.
Last night. It was great. Man. And I tell you, she was talking about Trump. It was a very controversial subject matter, and it was hilarious. It's great.
I always thought she was funny, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. She's brilliant. Brilliant.
23 after the hour. What else?
I guess we've got the Giants.
You're searching around for stuff?
No, when I got Beckham, that's a big story. You know, Beckham is...
Tell me what it is.
He wants to go to Los Angeles. He wants to play for the Rams.
Yeah.
But the Giants, especially John Mara, were like, slow down. We still love him. We're going to figure it out. In fact, here's the new Giants GM, my man, Dave Gettleman, on the future of Odell Beckham with the Giants.
Do you want Odell on your team?
I'm not going there. Next question.
Tell me. There's been a lot of stuff, right?
You
is
tell me.
Video?
Next question.
Who's that? Who's he talking to?
That's the Giants GM talking to some guy who asked him about Beckham. Yeah. Not exactly an enthusiastic endorsement.
It would be helpful if I paid attention, wouldn't it?
Well,
a little bit.
I just don't care anything about it. I guess that's the problem.
Yeah, I don't either, to be honest.
24 minutes after the hour, here's the great Levon Helm. I think I was at this concert in 1979, New Year's Eve. Well, 31 after the hour here in the Imus Morning Program. Geraldo Rivera is coming up with his brand new book, The Geraldo Show. Before that, time for a Bernie briefing. And that's brought to you by Bigelow Tea. And with that, Bernard McGurk. Good morning, Mr. McGurk.
Morning, Mr. Imus from the NJDiet.com studios. A lot of people, of course, wonder, Is with all the pressure and the noise, is the presidency taking its toll on President Trump? He was at a youth forum. Somebody asked him a question. Take a listen to this cut for Lou.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president.
I'd say the answer to my question is yes, taking some sort of a toll. And Conan O'Brien all over the Stormy Daniels situation, and he was funny. Take a listen.
Stormy Daniels did reveal very intimate details about her physical relationship with the president. Apparently, during climax, Donald Trump shouts, "Donald Trump!" Stormy Daniels did have a few other startling revelations about Trump. For example, Trump apparently has two comb-overs. So,
oh, gosh. And with that, boss, there's your briefing.
That's all you've got?
But, yeah, for now.
There's one of Geraldo Rivera's five favorite songs. A friend of Chris Christopherson wrote this.
Your morning dose of sunshine. Imus in the morning. Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
What was all that dead air about?
I don't know, 05.
Nothing we could do about it?
Nope.
Talking with Lou Ruffino here on the Imus Morning Program. We're going to talk with the Wyatt Imus and Deirdre Imus. Two single favorite people on God's earth. Coming up here in just a couple of minutes. And then we're going to talk with the great Rob Bartlett.
Yeah. Oh, baby.
Who
Whoa.
Is the single most talented person I've ever met. Whoa. I mean, remember we made a list one time of the characters he does?
Yeah.
It was about 50 on it.
Wow.
And then, of course, we've been to see every Broadway show he's ever in.
Are you one of those characters he does?
Does he do me?
Yeah.
No.
I mean, I would if I were. He's got, what, 50 years of material?
No.
Or 31 years.
He does me a little bit. It's not a great time. Yeah,
and I, Rob is brilliant. Wyatt was, I was pregnant with Wyatt when we were in the theater listening on Broadway, and Rob was on Broadway. So Wyatt's listened to Rob and has known his talent in utero.
Yeah,
pretty awesome.
About 20
years
of Rob.
He was kicking during the whole show, Rob.
Very big with the fetuses.
Dancing.
Anyway, Bernie, what's coming up this morning?
Well, you have that big meeting in China with Kim Jong-un and the president of China, President Xi. Trump has tweeted about it. People are talking about it. It's a big deal. And also the big debut of the long-awaited reunion of, the old show Roseanne. What's notable about it is she's pro-Trump on the show. And so a lot of people are taking notice. We'll play a clip or two from that.
You were wondering when it was on.
I know, I asked you.
It was on
you,
last night. We were watching The Voice.
After The Voice ended, I wondered about, I just thought of Roseanne. I think she's, I love Roseanne, so. I love how she's so bold.
Well, you watch it on YouTube, whatever.
Yeah, you can get, that's the thing. There's no appointment TV
right,
anymore.
Justin?
Yes, you can do that.
Yeah, it's on
demand, and it was
yeah.
great. You're going to love it. It didn't disappoint anybody. Hilarious. Even the serious subjects, you're going to laugh.
What do you have coming up?
Well, we got football news, I-Man. Will Peyton Manning be in the booth or not? Dan Patrick saying goodbye, getting ready for Deirdre's Villanova.
I don't quite understand that.
He doesn't want to do it anymore.
Huh?
He doesn't want to do it anymore. There's a need
I understand that, but that's a pretty good platform, and he's good at it.
Yes, true. And it seems kind of easy, show up on a Sunday night with Tony Dungy and Rodney Harrison and make millions of dollars. So
that's a pretty good show, too, didn't you think, or no?
No, it's terrible.
Awful. Really?
Oh, God. Terrible. It was even worse when Costas was there. But they don't do anything. They just go over highlights.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Terrible. But they make a lot of money.
Yeah,
they
you know who was
time.
Good this morning? Geraldo.
He was good. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But then he doesn't try to jerk my chain.
Right. You miss him now?
Do I miss him?
Yeah.
He's a great journalist. I'm going to tell you that now. Yep. And he let all that other stuff get in the way. So, the chance for hope, Dodge for a Cure, thing that you did at Rice University.
Yeah.
Raised $40,000.
Wow.
$40,677.
Yeah, it's remarkable that all these listeners that you've had for, well, some in and out all these years have.
What does in and out mean?
Well, I think we have to acknowledge that you've had your little couple of ups and downs here. And I mean, don't get me wrong, you've been phenomenal, but you have had a couple bumps. But all these consistent listeners who have wanted to contribute to me, and I'm really, honestly, really thankful for that. I mean, not me, but you know, the charity that I was talking about. They didn't have to listen to me, and they chose to, which I really think is great.
So this is your saying thank you to them?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay.
Well. And I'd like to add, too, that not only is this great for Chance for Hope, but this really wasn't too bad for my grade in the class, either.
That's right, I deserve an A.
Yeah. I mean, wouldn't you think, I really hope Professor Diane Crossey is listening, but wouldn't you think that after doing this for this charity as part of the class, I really do deserve an A?
Well, you'd get an A anyway, wouldn't you?
Well, yeah, you do get mostly A's anyway.
How's your classwork?
Things can go either way at Rice. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, you have great professors.
Oh, yeah.
This is all you two are bringing to my program this morning?
Well, we don't know. You always
we have after great a 50-year career.
And when I start to take over or start to, you tell me to back off and shut up and then a bunch of other things. Just like you do in real life.
Nobody wants to.
Off the air.
Nobody's interested in you coming in here and telling the truth.
I know. It's what everybody else is interested in, isn't it, honey? Playing to the audience your whole freaking life. Stop. Oh, my God. I love you. I love you. And Wyatt. You and Zach. You guys are, like, literally, I don't want to be with anyone else but you. I mean, you guys, I love you so much.
Right.
I'm still in love with you.
That's very good.
Since walking into the studio in 1992. And all these years, I mean, I want to also thank everyone, including everyone on your show, for all the support for the Imus Ranch all these years. Without all your listeners and fans donating all these years, I mean, it was a huge success taking care of these kids at the ranch. And that's a huge 20 years of
he
our
was
life.
There. Yeah.
So, no, but I want to thank you. I mean, here we go. This is it. This is it. The three of us sitting here on the air, this is it. For Imus in the morning on the air with you, me, and Wyatt.
What's going to happen after you go off? Like, who's going to take this time slot?
Bernie and Sid.
Oh, all right.
Don't you like them?
I love Bernie and Sid.
I love Bernie and Sid.
Oh, well, thank you.
We love you. The three of us think the world of the two of you.
They are really enormously talented,
and you're going to be hugely successful.
No, there's no question.
No question.
That's so sweet.
Thanks. Thank you. Bernie's going to be the new I Man, and then Sid will be the new Bernie.
That's right.
You've nailed it. Is that the way?
The apple did not fall far from the tree, man.
Not at all, guys. It's right there. It's the other testicle.
No, I think
they're going to
be.
That's funny.
They're going to be partners, Wyatt, Bernie and Sid.
You know, this could be phenomenal, or this could be like, you know, Journey when Steve Perry left.
It could go either way.
Yeah. That's just my feeling. I love them to death, but that's what could happen, I think. This could be like when Journey was going around with whoever that was.
Could go either way.
The number one fan.
That's so true, yeah.
Like when they had Steve Perry.
Can I get a little serious here?
Just a little. We don't have a lot of time.
I want to say I admire you so much, your professional life, too, here on the radio, because you, and I said it before, you're on my Mount Rushmore, but you, to me, are the best. You're the GOAT of radio. Absolutely. Hands down. And
You're not a Stern fan?
Never was. I mean, you know,
really?
He's okay.
Well, here's something. Here's the thing.
When you focus so much on...
Here's what you have to remember. I'm 77 years old, not 57 or 67.
I know.
I'm 77. I just happen to be, I haven't lost my mind yet. I still don't know what's going on, but I mean, any day now, I mean, I could forget, you know, I forget sometimes that we've done sports.
Yeah.
I could forget that we've done anything. I mean, that's not that far down the road.
No,
so.
I know. It has been a long, bumpy, real bumpy road, too.
So I was going to retire in December anyway.
I know.
So.
But I just want to congratulate you, too. I mean, for 50 years of awesomeness on the airwaves.
Yeah.
Now the onus is on you, Deirdre, to find a way to keep the I-Man busy.
Now that he's not doing the show, so. What are you going to do?
we're maxed out anyway. I mean, are you kidding me?
Like Sid, what?
It's never enough time for all the stuff we're doing.
The show occurs out here between 5 and 8 o'clock in the morning.
Right.
That's true. Early.
So, I've been here. I mean, nothing changes. So, I don't have to get up.
He's up at 10:30, yeah.
Well, then you'll have more energy, because as you guys know, getting up that early.
We've got to move along here. 13, 14 up the hour. Thank you both very much.
So, what are we moving on to?
I want to talk to Rob a little bit.
You know, Rob called me yesterday morning. Huh? It was an unknown caller, like you.
Yeah.
So I answered it, what do you want? But it was him, so it was exciting.
Oh.
Well, you've had the best collaborators. Your whole team has been the best. I mean, Robin is brilliant. And Tony, Tony's brilliant. I love Tony
Larry
also.
Kenny, Larry Kenny was unbelievable.
And Larry Kenny and Lou. Oh, my. Lou, I mean...
Talked to Lou yesterday, yeah.
Yeah. It's just,
anyway.
It was amazing.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. All of you guys. We love you.
Thank you.
Love you,
too. Thank you.
Love you,
Iron
Man.
See you, guys.
Yeah.
Love,
it's all about
so somebody
love.
Brought you, Rob, into this. Was that Mark Sheff?
It was Mark Sheff.
Wow.
And you came in, you did Tom Carvel, right?
Yep. That was the first thing I ever did.
Some funny stuff, wasn't it?
It was. And... You know, it's weird because my relationship with your program preceded that by, I don't know, about 10 years or so. I used to listen to you. I was a sophomore in high school, and I had a clock radio and used to wake up to you. That's 40-some-odd years ago. So I used to listen to you every morning before I go to school. And then never in my wildest imagination did I ever expect that I would be working with you for 31 years.
When did you get hired?
I got paid on a per-bit basis the last year at NBC. Uh-huh. And then when we moved over to WFAN, I was offered the contract.
Everything sort of changed when we moved over to FAN, didn't it?
Yeah, it was...
Because we stopped playing records.
Right, exactly. And then you started interviewing more people.
Well...
Some great times. Some great, great times. A lot of laughs.
Been fun.
It's been so much fun. And you know, and I know, you know.
Walk down that memory lane with me.
Come on.
Baby. Walk down that
memory lane.
I know my reputation, but in all sincerity, you know, none of what I have been able to achieve in my career would have happened if I hadn't had the exposure on your program.
Well, you don't know that.
I do.
Not sure to say. But
no, I mean, it's that kind of exposure.
Talented people are talented people, and I think they find a way to emerge regardless. So.
And making you laugh is one of the single greatest things in the world. Absolutely.
Well, you've done that a lot, yeah. So. Not a lot. Not much as you could.
That's it, Fatso?
I don't know what I'm going to do. That's, you know, I don't know who's going to
call
me a fat bastard anymore. Will you, Tony, call me?
I'll call you.
All right.
Yeah. Twice a day.
But it's been a great ride, man, and I got to thank you.
Well, you're more than welcome. So it's just, you know, I like back when Charles left, I was going to stop then. Part of the reason lay it all out here. Part of the reason I haven't stopped way before this is you.
Wow.
And Lou, Bernie. Then we got Connell, and we'll talk to Connell about that coming up here later. But that was just pure luck, because if we hadn't got Connell, there was nobody there. There was nobody to get. So, and the way the show was structured, I had to have that.
No, he was seamless.
But, you've been great, so. I love you to death.
I love you, too.
I wish you were going someplace, but.
Me, too.
Eventually you will.
Oh, he's going someplace.
Can't stay hidden.
But here's the problem.
If you ever come back to New York, I'll be outside the Midtown Tunnel with a squeegee, so.
Here's the problem. I pay you guys so much money that you can't get another job making that kind of money.
Yeah.
So those are the facts. I mean, Lou gets paid more than a talent does, but then Lou's the talent, too, so. Mm-hmm. All right, baby. Well, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, 18 minutes after the hour here on the Imus Morning Program. We did a little news, didn't we, Bernie, or not?
Some treetops we did, indeed.
That's enough.
That's plenty.
Let's do some sports, and here with that is
Sid.
Sid Rosenberg.
Oh, hi, Imus.
It's happening.
Sid.
It's all happening.
Nice. not a moment too soon.
When does the football draft come up?
April 26th, Iman.
Do you have any thoughts on that, Wyatt?
Yeah, two words, Baker Mayfield.
Yeah, but I'm with you, Wyatt. I think he's the best quarterback in the draft, but there's going to be two or three taken before him.
Yeah, and they'll be horrible.
Probably. In fact, the Browns have the number one pick overall, and they are, it looks like.
Sam Darnold, right?
Yes, yes, out of USC. In fact, Wyatt, here's the Browns GM, John Dorsey, lying to all of us.
We still have different phases that we're going to work with. I want to go back, have a chance to listen to everybody. So, we're not finished yet trying to put this thing to bed. So, there's still a lot of discussions that's going to take place. And at the end of the day, we're going to make what's best for this organization moving forward.
Which is what Wyatt just said. Sam Darnold. The bigger question is Giants at number two and Jets at number three. Who are they going to take?
I thought the New York Jets were, or the Giants, I mean, where they're talking about maybe trading down because they don't need a quarterback. Apparently, they think Eli can get it done with his 30 picks a year. I don't know.
30 picks and 37 years old. So, yeah. Giants need a quarterback, but we'll see what they may still trade Beckham. We'll see what they do coming up in the draft.
Who else do you like in the draft, Wyatt?
I like the kid from Penn State, Saquon Barkley?
Yes, the running back.
Right.
I like the kid from Alabama, Minkah Fitzpatrick. I think he's really good.
Yes,
he could.
I think Baker Mayfield. I think Lamar Jackson. No one talks about him enough. I think he's great.
Good call. Louisville quarterback. Very good player.
He's real fast.
Yes.
Action
yes.
Jackson, man.
Yeah. Action Jackson. Bernie's all over this. They should do ESPN Bernie and Wyatt. That should be draft day coverage.
No doubt.
Wyatt, say something about one of these players. Go ahead. Any players?
I think Baker Mayfield has the kind of attitude that can lead a franchise. Isn't that something one of those guys would say?
Just look at the tapes.
Yeah.
This is perfect. Like, this is awesome.
Give me another one, Wyatt. Give me one more, Wyatt. Go ahead.
I think people overlook Lamar Jackson. He was really accurate in college, and he's got world-class speed.
Bernie?
The potential is exponential.
There you go.
That's one after awesome. The hour. There's Guns N' Roses.
Oh, my God.
One of Wyatt Imus' five favorite songs. Thank you, Wyatt. Thank you, honey. As you know, watch you bleed, baby. Thank you very much, Bernie.
Yes, sir.
Doing a pretty good job reading them spots. Come on now. Yeah. 29 after the hour here at the Imus Morning Program. Delbert McClinton coming up. And Colin McShane still coming up. So, time for a little. We did sports.
We did.
Yes.
Yes, we did.
Not only did you do sports, your son was involved in it.
That's right.
Hello.
You got to remember that, wasn't you?
And they shot John F. Kennedy. I'm in.
I don't think that's funny, son.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Well, not they. It was one guy.
That was one guy, right.
Allegedly.
Right. Well, we don't know that. We don't know that.
I mean, all that grass and knoll now.
Yeah. Got that Chappaquiddick movie coming out.
Oh, yeah.
Well, no, that's. Well, how is that funny? Somebody died. How is that amusing?
Really?
Well, anything. Because you know why it's amusing, I'll tell you why.
Because you had a lady yesterday on who was on the show.
Right.
Sternberg.
Who was on
agent for 50 years or something like that.
She was looking for a ride off the island with Ted Kennedy, and he left her behind.
That's
because he wanted to get jiggy with old Mary Jo.
Right.
Well, yeah.
And he didn't.
The deal was there was a party there that night.
Right.
There were seven women there. And they all worked for Kennedy in the office in D.C.
Mm-hmm.
And, they were having a little bonfire party. And so the Senator Kennedy he'd like to apparently marry Joe.
Well,
so
he took the best looking one.
Right.
And all the excess baggage.
Well, Lobster was pretty good looking in those. She's still pretty good looking. Well, she's an attractive. She's not an unattractive woman.
No, she's not. Except Ted Kennedy was a little drunk, so he didn't realize that.
Well, thank God, or we wouldn't have Esther.
Oh, that would be terrible.
And we're sorry that Mary Jo Kopechne had to die.
Well,
yeah.
And
will the I-Man go see the movie?
No, I will not.
What?
Well, why would I go see the movie?
It's history.
Might be very well done.
Pertains to you.
It's actually Chappaquiddick, and they use the hashtag, this really happened.
Yeah.
I swear to God.
You know what's good about it?
Well, I'll watch it, but I'm not going to some theater.
No way. No.
What's good about it, I-Man, is that every time we bring up the movie, it gives Bernard the opportunity to do Ted Kennedy, and that is hilarious.
No, it's not funny, though. This is sad, a tragic topic. No.
Just do the voice.
We're not going to mock the death of a young
do
lady.
Do the voice.
Esther Newberg. No room in the car for you. You will stay behind and wait for the ferry, like the rest of these women.
Something.
Put that fire out.
See, it's funny. See?
Let me ask you this, Senator Kennedy.
Go ahead, Imus.
You bastard.
Why didn't you try to save Mary Jo?
I had to get back to the motel and call the police as quickly as possible.
This is not funny. I said, you know, you're a sick bastard. 32 after the hour.
Do the voice!
Bernie, do you have a briefing?
Well, yes, I do.
Do it as Ted Kennedy, the whole
do it
briefing.
Again.
Now, Maxine Waters, she of the low IQ, she was asked, she was actually on MSNBC.
Yeah.
And she was on a panel with your friend, Mike Lupica, believe it or not.
Yeah.
That's what it's come to. Mike Lupica is on a panel with Maxine Waters. And the host actually played a clip of Maxine Waters 20 years ago talking about the impeachment of Bill Clinton, much to her surprise. This is how that went.
This was you making that type of claim against the Republicans pursuing Bill Clinton in that impeachment. Take a look.
Okay. All right. I am greatly disappointed in the raw, unmasked, unbridled hatred and meanness that drives this impeachment coup d'etat. The unapologetic disregard for the voice of the people. My Republican friends, what you do here today will long be remembered and recorded in history as one of the most despicable actions ever taken by the Congress of the United States of America.
Now the host said, well, given what you said then, what about now?
What do you say to people who argue that the Democrats in the House may go down that road?
Well, I want to tell you that the Democrats have been very, very responsible and even saying to me that I should not be calling for impeachment. Let the investigation go on. And they've said to me that let's just talk about our issues. Let's not talk about him. This just emboldens the Republicans who say that the only reason that you would want impeachment is because you don't like it.
God, shut her up.
You, Ms. Waters, you made that name up just to make me look bad. How dare
all
you?
All the songs after. Thank you, Senator Kennedy.
Where's my dog Splash?
Of all the songs out there, this is my favorite. The great Deborah McLean.
The Wild West of Talk Radio. Imus in the morning. Imus in the morning.
You know that I've spent the last 10 minutes trying to find Sid? It's just so frustrating.
Yeah.
I can't believe what you're going to have to go through, Bernie.
Well, no, listen. It's part of what makes him great, actually.
Yeah. Here's the thing.
Take the bad with the good.
You know what that says?
What's that, boss?
Well, how terrific he is. Because I always want to talk to him.
Oh. Bingo.
Thank you.
So I'm not just, shut up, Sid.
Cut me up.
You're making me sad.
Well, no, there's nothing to be sad about, but. So, Colin McShane's coming up, and he's the last guest
Wow.
On this program, and tomorrow, there's no guests.
Do you remember the very first guest ever you ever had? Connor would be the last. Remember the first?
No, I do not.
Yes.
You do?
Oh, you do?
Yes, it was.
You're being serious, sir. Get ready for this.
Was Woodrow Wilson's Calvin vice president.
There we go.
He was searching for the president.
I thought you were serious.
No, come on.
I remember the first record I ever played.
What was that?
I'm going to play it tomorrow.
Oh, wow.
At 7:05 Eastern Time.
Oh, cool.
So.
You don't remember the first political guest you ever had? Political. I guess it was Bush.
Might have been Lowell Weicker.
Is that right?
That's a very good guess.
Yeah, it's a good guess.
Yeah?
He, former governor of Connecticut.
Could have been Al D'Amato, maybe?
Alphonse was the regular.
Now, how many presidents over the years have you had on?
Let me just think. Three or four?
Wow.
And Obama, Bill Clinton, Bush 41.
Right. Fair to assume that 41, I mean, was your favorite on-air guest out of all the presidents?
Yeah, he was great.
Yeah,
he really was.
I mean, it was funny. So, he'd done some homework, you know?
Yeah.
Clinton was pretty good. So.
Dick Cheney?
Was Dick Cheney on?
Yeah.
Actually live.
Yeah.
Wow.
Called him pork chop butt.
That's right. He's the pork chop butt thing.
Wow.
But it wasn't really about that, you know? I don't know.
No.
I'll talk a little bit tomorrow about what it was about.
I'm surprised Jimmy Carter was never on.
Oh. Well, was he ever on, Bernie?
That preceded me. I don't believe he was ever on after he was president.
Probably not, no. What's going on in the news?
Well, the huge news about the North Korean president. This is historic, what's happened here. The North Korean president in China, he took a train. It was the first time he ever left the country, his own country, since he became dictator. And it's all been confirmed now. They put out pictures of him standing there with his wife and the Chinese.
What's she look like? Probably him, huh?
No,
she's
not. No, he's really porky.
She's not that bad.
She's not that bad at all. No, not at all. I'm sure she's thrilled to be married to this guy, but it doesn't matter. But the president's actually tweeting out this morning. He said he received a message last night from Xi Jinping of China that the meeting with Kim Jong-un went very well, and that Kim looks forward to his meeting with me. This is what Trump is saying. In the meantime, and unfortunately, maximum sanctions and pressure must be maintained at all cost.
Yeah.
Now, the Maryland Senator Ben Cardin, he's with the Foreign Relations Committee, he says that Kim Jong-un was likely in China to reassure his relations with that country. This is in the news.
Which news?
This is the 7 o'clock news, Lou. Yeah.
Kim Jong-un is trying to shore up his relationship with China. It has been rough at times. We know that. There's some problems between North Korea and China. He's going to be negotiating with the United States, wants to get more friends in that region.
But this is all about denuclearization. This is absolutely a big, big deal that he's going to denuclearize. He's talking to everybody and that the Chinese president is talking to the United States president about it all. And our good friend Gordon Chang, he was on Fox News with your friend Martha McCallum, and they were talking about the tough tariffs that Trump has put on China and a tweet that Trump put out. Listen to McCallum talking to Gordon Chang.
This tweet from President Trump back on March the 2nd. He said, when a country, USA, is losing many billions of dollars on trade with virtually every country it does business with, trade wars are good and easy to win. Example, when we're down $100 billion with a certain country, I can insert China into that, and they get cute, don't trade anymore. We win big. It's easy. Your thoughts on that, Gordon?
Yeah, economists are going to be horrified, but Trump is actually right. You know, we can win this trade war.
How do you like that?
Would you
Are you sick of all this winning yet?
I mean, you're going to miss Gordon Chang?
I did like him.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's good.
Now,
good
be thing. Honest, you are never going to watch. I know Hannity's your buddy. You love Sean Hannity, blah, blah, blah.
you're never going to watch any of that stuff again.
Any of what stuff again?
This new stuff and Fox News.
Well, no. Why would I not do that?
Would you care? I mean, we have to talk about it
in
the morning.
Well, I'm not going to do the Imus in the Morning program anymore.
Right. So.
But that doesn't mean I'm not going to do something.
Oh.
Ooh.
See this?
I hear what's going there. On.
Here.
Little tease, baby.
There's one. I can tell you this much.
Tucker Carlson's out?
No. I'm not going to do that.
No.
There's one more big thing I'm going to do.
Seriously?
I just told you. There's one more big thing I'm going to do.
That's a big enough.
Well, how are we going to find out about it?
Well, you'll hear about it.
Can you announce it on the Bernie and Sid show?
Pardon me?
What's that?
What I do on your show, I might.
All right.
Oh, look at this.
Yes.
Got to follow where my Imus
is
at.
But you can go. How do they get in touch with me, Bernie?
Rob?
Where am I Imus at?
Where am I Imus at?
Well, if I go to where my Imus at, it says Imus. Mm-hmm. And then underneath that, it says at where my Imus at. How come it doesn't say at where my Imus at on top there?
Because it's the name of the person and then the handle.
That's the way you do it?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Right.
So this is done properly?
Yes, it is.
That's good you mentioned it because people were looking for you at Imus in the Morning, but that no longer exists.
Well, no, it never existed. It was at the Imus show.
Okay, gotcha.
Well, why can't I? I can change the name of that to where my Imus at, couldn't I? Couldn't I change my name to that?
You should. Let me check.
Not very helpful here.
Yeah. But you got to know your password and all that.
I know what it is.
Okay.
Don't worry about that.
Whatever you want.
I'm doing it now, I think.
When should people check back for this major announcement? Francesca's going to make an announcement this week, too. This is too much.
Done.
It's done? Congratulations on it.
What'd you do? What's done?
It says where my Imus at now.
Where my Imus at, everybody? How about that?
It's all good to go.
Yep.
That's what it says. Where my Imus at.
Yeah.
See?
Oh, imagine that.
It's amazing.
So that's technology. Sure we want to do it that way?
Jesus, make up your mind. One or the other.
I wouldn't. I go back the other way. I'm going to come back later.
I think you got to go back to the other way.
Till 10 o'clock.
Sounds frivolous.
Where my Imus at? And then... you can leave at Imus in the Morning if you want. I mean, I'm not going to. No, I mean, the show's going to end, so.
Yeah, but people know you as Imus in the Morning, right. So why wouldn't you just.
Well, just leave it there then. That's fine.
That's right. A good plan.
Right. You have anything else, Sid?
Me?
No.
Yes. Actually, Gunzelman had a very good question for you, but only he could ask it. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Because I have no idea. It's kind of like Mike Golick with Ronda Rousey.
Unintelligible.
I was in an Uber, and that Build Me a Buttercup song came on. I remember years ago that you introed it by going through the alphabet, and it would start with Y for Why Do You... What's one of your favorite songs to kick to or speak up or, you know, shout out to, awesome. Lead up to?
Great.
Don cool. Gardner and Dee Dee Ford and I Need Your Lovin' was one.
I know you did like Righteous Brothers, right?
Try to Find Another Man.
I
used to work that record.
Oh God, that was great.
Come on, dog. Hmm.
So I grew up on R&B disc jockeys. Herman Griffin, all the guys out in L.A., Hunter Hancock, and all the guys at KGFJ in L.A., so. We'll talk all the way through a record, Have a conversation with the person singing the record. Talking to Ruth Brown, people like that. Person Sliz, people like that. So.
Think we could get one more of that? For me, at least.
Just do it. The kid is heartbroken.
I got no job. I got nothing lined up. I want to.
It's got nothing.
Could I do like another Try to Find Another Man?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Come on, Daddy.
One more time.
We probably could do that. Maybe after that, we'll do this, then we'll do. We can drag that up, can we, Lou?
I have it.
Hey, Imus, you want to hear something really depressing?
Yeah.
So tomorrow, when you drop the mic and say goodbye. No, Gunzelman planned this.
Well, I would say goodbye before I dropped the mic.
That's a good point. Yeah. Gunzelman has planned this Exit Imus lunch tomorrow.
Yeah.
So there's a bar across the street by Madison Square Garden.
Yeah.
And he's invited a bunch of people to come and get drunk and have lunch and pretty much say goodbye. Isn't that depressing? A little? It is, right? Okay.
Yeah.
If you were in town, would you go to this?
Of course not.
Are you kidding?
It's the last time I'm going to see a lot of these people.
You know who I haven't heard from at all?
Who?
Anybody at the radio station. Not that I need to, but is that kind of weird?
That's very weird. Mm. It's weird. It's disrespectful, actually. And weird, huh?
Well,
it kind of is. I mean,
where's the love?
About that, but yeah. I mean,
that's not right.
I haven't heard from Leslie, but
yeah,
it's odd, isn't it?
Yes,
that hurts.
It's not right.
Well, I know.
It's not right.
No, fine.
No, it hits you right here.
Yeah.
Almost 25 after the hour here in the Imus & Wyatt program. Once again, have you done sports yet, Sid?
Not really, but, you know, thinking about all the years and all the shows that you've done, and they've all been great for four decades, but, you know, you told the story that a lot of people, and you're right about this, if they weren't watching Monday Night Football the night before, a lot of people found out from you that John Lennon had been shot and killed.
Been murdered,
yeah. But I think everybody found out from you when that first plane and second plane hit. 9/11, you were on... I don't know how many hours you were on that day. I'll never forget.
14, I think.
14. And you know you'll be humble, but you were great that day, amazing that day. You think, Matt, is that maybe the day you'll remember most? Or not that?
Well, you know, I don't know whether it is or not, but it's such shock. And Warner was on too with us. You know, he was great.
He was.
I don't know. I mean, in the middle of it, I didn't recognize the significance. I mean, as it was happening, you know. But as I look back on it, of course, it was. So. But, you know, I had a different, I'm going to talk about this in the morning a little bit, as much as I can get through it. A different relationship with the audience and with my perception of it. I didn't realize until I got to thinking about it just a few weeks ago. So, I don't remember the I'm Mr. Wayne program in that way. And I'll try to explain that tomorrow, so... Certain, I mean, does it make any sense at all? Or
yes, it does. It does.
So.
Yeah.
All right, who's the Righteous Brothers? I think you better try to find another man.
I think you better. I think you better try to find another man.
Oh, yeah.
Try to find one who'll love you. Yeah. And live with you the best you can. Don't stop none of that grieving. This time I'm leaving. Packing up my suitcase.
Walking out that door.
Try to find another man.
That's right. Come on, baby. Let's do it. Sorry.
When I first met you.
Oh, yeah.
You were such a sweet thing.
Such a sweet thing.
You meant everything to me. So I took you for my bride. Yeah, but in 5 years you've changed. And now you'll never do nothing. All you ever do is sit around the TV set, feed your fat face, complain, and make life a complete misery.
Good.
I think you better. I think you better try to find another man. Try to find one who'll love you. And live with you the best you can. Don't start none of that grieving. This time I'm leaving.
Packing up my
suitcase.
Walking out the door.
Try to find another man.
Oh yeah, now come on now, come on now.
From the early hours of the morning till the late hours at night. You keep on nagging me, baby. Jump on me. I'll do nothing. There's lots of boxy bellies in the scene. I'm gonna give me one just on me. Well,
That's a great awesome. Question, brothers.
That was great. That was
cool. It is 29 after the hour here on the Imus of the Morning Program. God, they were great. The Righteous Brothers, and that's before they got with Phil Spector. You know, I actually saw them record You Lost That Love and Feeling.
Huh. Wow.
At Gold Star Recording there in Hollywood. They sang to the track that Phil had done. You know, and the track is one of the more famous tracks in the history of recording. Gene Page was the announcer. I mean, was the arranger for that. And people like, had three piano players on that session. Leon Russell was one of them. James Byrd, they all played on that record. And then the Righteous Brothers, I remember seeing them stand in Studio A there, had all the lights off. They had a spotlight on them. And they had taken their shoes off. And they were singing to the track, "Oh, You Lost That Love and Feeling." And they didn't do it very many times. And then I remember Phil, Gold Star Recording Studio, not a big place. Studio 8 and another studio or something. Then I remember watching Phil there with, he had a little tiny radio speaker in which he would master, in which he would finish all of the records through. He would listen to that and see how they sounded coming through that. And that's the way he would release them. He did that with You Lost That Love and Feeling. So.
Did you party with Phil Spector, boss?
No, I did not.
Not that night.
No. I wasn't into, but you know, I didn't drink really until I was, I really didn't drink until I came to New York. I was like 30. So I drank a little bit when I was in the mines there at the Grand Canyon, but I'm drinking scotch in those days. Drinking that Chivas Regal. Yeah. But that's what my father drank. But I wound up like a real drunk drinking that vodka.
No joke. That
Stolzenauer, come on, baby.
A manly drunk.
Well, is there any sports you want to report, Sid?
Well,
no?
there's one that's kind of funny, I think. I brought it up earlier. We did play it in the 6 o'clock hour. But it is worth playing again. And that is Mike Golic, the ESPN morning show host.
He's so terrible.
So bad.
I mean, it's like kicking.
Kicking me.
It's like kicking a baby seal, you know?
Yes, it is. But it's,
why do we want to do that?
It's funny.
And there may be a new job open.
What the hell with that? All right. Ronda Rousey sitting down with Mike Golic and one of your aspiring young radio hosts. You may not want to go down his interviewing route. Go ahead.
Audio.
Start with when you knew from the MMA, when you were done there, when you knew in your mind, I'm not going to fight anymore.
I never said that.
Ah, so there is a possibility that you could go back in time?
There's a possibility that I can go back in time? That's your question to me?
Go back in time and fight. Go back in the octagon.
I do not have the ability to go back in time, no.
No. Would you fight again?
I don't know.
Kind of like Terry Francona, yeah, right? She was a half a B-word, too. I know, but... You know, I mean, like, when in your mind did you know you're not going to fight in the MMA? There was a point, and that was after she got her ass kicked the second time after her...
She could have answered that.
Holly Holm.
He's just it's brutal, but... Well, he doesn't know how to talk, but I mean, there's no reason to beat him up about it.
No, come on.
Is there?
Yes.
Yeah. It's only his job to talk.
So. Is he a threat to you and Bernie?
No.
Well, then leave him alone.
Nobody's a threat to me and Bernie.
Screw him.
Nobody. Not Berman, not Renal, not Boomer.
That's laughable.
I mean, come on.
The competition you have is laughable.
It's not great, is it?
No, it's not. 33 after the hour. Bernie, do you have anything in a briefing?
I have the big Roseanne debut last night. That was huge, notable
tell,
because
tell me about it.
She, of course, what's again notable about it is that she's a Trump supporter in the land of leftist radical Hollywood,
And she brought the character. The character herself also is a pro-Trump. It's a sort of a middle America type of family. You remember the show from the old days?
Sure.
Anyway, so last night, here's a clip. Last night, stop the clip. Last night, you have Aunt Jackie is bringing Roseanne some dressing, and this happens.
Here's some dressing for the table.
Oh, look, Dan, Russian.
Penny Rose.
Oh, it's my little princess.
Or senator, or doctor, or captain of industry, because girls can be whatever they want to be.
Aunt Jackie thinks every girl should grow up and be president, even if they're a liar, liar, pantsuit on fire.
How do you like that? On ABC.
Pretty good.
And then there was this, play Cthulhu.
First, let's say grace. Jackie, would you like to take a knee? Dear Lord, thank you for this food and for bringing our son DJ home safe from Syria. But most of all, Lord, thank you for making America great again.
Wow.
All right.